Okay. What I've noticed is that there is a trend of using data in team sports like soccer, basketball, and rugby, to use data to improve on training, to improve training of the athletes, to reduce injuries, and even to predict injuries. So I wanted to ask you, how far is this process gone? How much can you predict from the data you get? And is this also applicable for martial arts? Because I haven't heard it being used for martial arts yet.
Yeah, that's an interesting question, pretty tough to answer. So first of all, the research showed there's a connection between changes in training. Also, if you're doing too much too soon, that's associated with increased risk of injury, pretty much soft tissue injury or non-contact injuries. The contact injuries you cannot predict, especially in combat sports and as well as team sports. But predicting injury is still pretty much a pipe dream. So in statistical modeling, we have two cultures. We have a, I would say, inferential culture where you try to create a statistical inference, trying to find association. And then on the other side, like the other culture, is trying to actually predict what's going to happen. So most of the research that's done in papers, the published papers and journals, it's on an inferential side. But now, luckily, sports scientists are catching up and starting to use machine learning techniques and trying to actually see how predictable our models are in actually trying to predict the injuries. And I did some analysis a few times, and I'm reading a few papers. It's still quite a pipe dream. And even if you know a prediction, say if I tell you you're an athlete, and I tell you based on your training load that you've been doing for the last 1 month, you have a prediction. You have a probability, a likelihood that you're going to get injured 0.8. How are you going to use that in practice? So how is that going to affect psychologically the athlete? And this is something that's called Lucas critique. So when I know those parameters or estimates of likelihood of getting injured, any intervention I do based on those estimates is going to affect the estimates itself. So it's like I call it the Terminator problem, because if you know the future, if you do something now, is it going to change the future or not? So it's I would say it kind of goes into philosophy as well. So
sure. Since we're on that subject, I was tested by an FMS test when I was training MMA in Sweden. I really had a very, very bad result. Out of possible 21 points, I got 7. And in theory, the FMS test can determine whether you will be injured or not. I mean, the likelihood of you getting injured. And that, as I've heard, was important for American football coaches, so they can determine which of their athletes are likely to get injured and what they need to do to prevent those injuries in the gym or maybe with stretching or whatever. So what is your opinion about the FMS test and similar tests that claim to predict the injuries before they happen?
The research actually showed that it's not really predictable of injury, and that's only one aspect of, I would say, the complete package. So if you're a couch potato and you have a really bad FMS score, you're not going to get injured because you don't put any load on yourself. But if you're training hard, so the load is the most important thing, and this is kind of like a modulator or modified how you're going to respond to that load. So if you have a crappy bad movement, that's going to probably affect it. But again, when you read websites and coaches and watch videos, everything seems so quite clear and very simple. So if you have this score, you're gonna have a likelihood of getting injured. But in reality, it's not that simple. There are a lot of things involved, and we also see that research showing very low correlation between quality of movement and likelihood of getting injured. So you probably know from working with athletes, you have guys who are moving perfectly and they're just injury prone, and you have guys who are like hunchback and they're just robust. So, and they have really very bad mobility and all that stuff. So it's not very simple. I see it as a baseline tool, something to use. Like it's better than nothing, that's for sure. And especially if you don't see someone, or if you see him for the first time, or if you're working in a big group, it gives you something that you can work from, but it's not the end all be all, if that makes sense.
Yeah, it does make sense, and there are so many factors involved when it comes to people, when it comes to athletes. So yeah, that makes perfect sense. If you want to master MMA fundamentals, check out my instructional called MMA Essential Lessons. In it, you can learn about clinch takedowns, boxing, grappling, Muay Thai, ground and pound, Thai and puppet master clinch, escapes from inferior positions, and shooting takedowns. Check out the link in the description below.